The movie begins with the announcement of an intergalactic martial arts tournament hosted by millionaire Excess Cash as a birthday gift to his son. Cash also announces the now supposed savior of the Earth, Mr. Satan's participation in the tournament. The next day, the tournament's prelims are officially underway, with the Z Fighters participating, with the exception of the now deceased Goku and demotivated Vegeta. Holy shit! Even Yamcha and Tien are in here! Gohan, Trunks, Krillin, Piccolo, and Tien all advance to the semifinals. As Goku and King Kai watch on an otherworld, all of them, except Piccolo and Tien, easily advance to the finals, taking place on a smaller island. At the finals, each participant is assigned a different tunnel to go in, housing the four fighters supposedly across the four galaxies. All part of a race to be the first to return to the island and face Mr. Satan. However, when they all arrive at their battle zones, they are each greeted by entirely different opponents, two of whom make quick work of Krillin and the sumo wrestler stereotype. Trunks fights with and is eventually taken out by another. King Kai watches on at everything and explains to Goku that this is the work of a space pirate named Bojack and his crew, and how he and the rest of the Kais trapped them inside of a star which was destroyed when King Kai's planet was blown up by Cell. Gohan finds the unconscious bodies of Krillin and Trunks, and is finally introduced to Bojack himself. Tien and Yamcha join in, but are quickly taken out by his crew, leading to Gohan going Super Saiyan and managing to solo most of them. Per usual, Piccolo joins the fight along with Trunks and now Vegeta. They all continue fighting Bojack and his crew until Mr. Satan flies in on a rocket shuttle and distracts them long enough for Gohan to keep fighting. However, Bojack begins crushing the life out of him, and without any other ally by his son's side, Goku decides to... Goku gives his son a pep talk, leading to the now motivated Gohan, for the first time proper in these movies, transform into a Super Saiyan 2. As he approaches the crew, two of them attempt to stop him, only to get f***ing eviscerated by him. Bojack also kills the remaining crew member and vows to kill Gohan before being delivered what I like to call the signature Super Saiyan gut punch. Gohan delivers a Kamehameha wave, finally killing Bojack, as Goku looks on in pride at his son. The movie ends with Mr. Satan being credited with saving the world twice, and also an exact repeat of Super Android 13's ending. And you know what that means? Wow, even down to the shot of Piccolo and Vegeta. So Bojack and his crew bring back a trope that you all may be familiar with at this point, which was absent from the previous movie. That trope being, from how I see it, a big bad leader with a powerful form accompanied by largely forgettable teammates. With the addition of said teammates, this means that Bojack himself really doesn't get much time to shine as a character. Not only that, but let's also welcome back the evil alien trope! Bojack really doesn't have that big of a twist on it, besides the fact he leads a crew of space pirates who are trapped in a star. In my eyes, Cooler still has the award of being the best of this trope, while Bojack, among all these other movie villains, lands somewhere in the middle. Overall, he's fine, but I personally would have wanted to see more backstory from him. Also his crew, not the most forgettable teammates, but not the best either. Moving on, the animation is largely the same quality of the previous movie, since Tadayoshi Yamamoto is now on to officially stay as animation director for all these movies following. I almost want to say it is basically the same. But with the addition of Super Saiyan 2, I'll give the slight edge to this movie for its animation fidelity. This movie also has some pretty great shots in it as well, this one with Gohan killing Bojack being my favorite. There's a reason why I mostly choose my favorite shots from these movies as thumbnails. As for the pacing though, it suffers a bit more than some of the other aspects of the movie for me. The entire first half of this movie almost felt like a chore getting through it. I think they spent too much time focusing on the prelims and the semifinals of the tournament. I mean, this movie basically does need to show where these characters have been following the Cell games, especially with Gohan, but I think for certain characters, they have either too little or too much time given to them. Like, Krillin did not need as much time as he got in the first half. He was almost always comedic relief that barely landed with me. On the other hand, characters like Piccolo, and especially Yamcha and Tien, I feel should have had more time and action spent with them. With Yamcha and Tien in particular, this movie is the last of two movies these two ever appear in before not only becoming irrelevant in the Buu arc going forward, but also being gutted entirely from all movies afterward. I may sound like a diehard fan of these two. Maybe I am. I'm just saying, these two need their time to truly shine again. I mean, Super had Tien participate and suck ass in the Tournament of Power, while Yamcha got an episode dedicated to baseball! I could make an entire video on how these two faded into obscurity. Don't quote me on that. Anyways, I also intentionally neglected to mention this side plot with Mr. Satan being a pussy as usual. Which, it's funny, but it's also just nothing more than filler. However, at least it provided the breathing room in between action I thought Broly's movie lacked. Oh, and one more thing. This is f***ing stupid. Finally, for the score, I watched both the English and Japanese scores again, which I'll be doing for all movies going forward, and yeah, you still can't beat the Japanese version. What I liked about the score in this movie in particular is how some of the tracks made for this movie came back as essentially character motifs in the Buu arc. In fact, all the movies prior to this follow this trend with its corresponding arc. Two examples I immediately noticed upon hearing them were, one, Trunks fighting Tien in the semifinals has the same music most commonly associated with the Great Saiyan Man.
Man, school sure seems closer when I fly there myself. At this rate, I'm gonna have a lot of free time on my hands.
And two, the entire Super Saiyan 2 sequence also has the same music that pretty much everyone associates with Majin Vegeta. Oh, and by the way, the music made for the Buu arc is easily my favorite from DBZ, rivaled only by the Cell Saga. Now, of course, we can't forget the American score. Nothing special, but to be honest, it resembles stuff we're used to hearing by now, so... Okay, I think I've gone on long enough about this movie. So to cap off all movies covered so far before the 7-year time skip, Bojack Unbound gets... a 7 out of 10. The movie has shown to me that it deserves the hype it gets from everyone online, despite big pacing issues and an unfortunately forgettable antagonist.